Kristy Medo from exercisethoughties.com, and this is WNRB LP WASA. ExercisesAuthorities.com. Today I'm delivering you my show, which is Live Well, Be Well, and I'm here every Tuesday from 5 p.m. until 6 p.m. Things I'll share with you are various elements of health, fitness, mental wellness in relationship to thereof, and a lot of comedy to go with it. A little bit about myself. I am a personal trainer, and I train people on various levels and different abilities. I take kids who are trying to train for specific sports, adults who are trying to lose weight, reduce stress, change their body overall, improve health, things like diabetes. People come to me with those issues as well, and they work on it through exercise and proper diet. I work with seniors, people who are post-rehabilitation from different injuries, all the way up to the fun sports of bodybuilding and fitness competitions. I also do national-level bodybuilding and figure judging through an organization called the NPC, which stands for the National Physique Committee. And through all of those things, I get to meet all of you wonderful people. So I welcome you to send me any questions that you have to questions@exercisesauthorities.com.
Kristy, I want to jump in here real quick. My name is Dino. I'm going to help out from time to time with the show. So what I think I'm most interested in right off the bat is how you got into this business. Because this wasn't your first career.
No, it wasn't my first career. Actually, I went to school for machining. So
I didn't even know that.
Yeah, totally. Way off the mark. Most people don't know that.
Machining? Okay.
I went to our lovely North Central Technical College for about 2 years to acquire my machining certificate to go out into the world to chisel away at metal parts. However, I got out there and I realized that this probably wasn't something that I could tolerate for, you know, long days chiseling away at metal. It didn't spark my interest beyond, you know, it was a good career.
Okay, well, I don't mean to interrupt or anything like that, but when did you go to NTC? How old were you?
I was 18, right?
So right out of college, you're an 18-year-old girl and you thought, I want to be a machinist.
You know, I'm an extremist, so therefore I
even as an 18-year-old girl, yeah. You were, yeah, but, yeah, okay, so why, not to get off the exercise task or anything like that, but seriously, why machinist?
Well, it's all about chiseling away and chiseling sculpting away. Things.
Nice. You see that, folks, how she got back to that?
Yep, right back to the exercise. Okay. This all leads into it.
So you gave up your career as a machinist, and then what happened?
Then I thought I was going to be a lawyer. So I improved my communication skills and started to acquire my general education through UW-Marathon County. And I decided that that would probably alter my personality and make me a little bit more edgy than I already was. So then I sought out on the path of stress reduction and started racing dirt bikes.
Sorry, folks. I knew that that was coming, and I just, this is an awesome career arc.
So, you know, I kind of quit the school thing and just went to the regular 8 to 5 in order to pursue the free time of my evenings to go to practice racing in wide open dirt, jumps, flying through the air, adrenaline pumping through my body in extreme ways. You know, this was what attracted me. But, you know, over the course of time, I started to take more risks, which meant more crashing. And crashing meant more concussions. And after about 4 concussions, I decided that it was probably time to hand it in for something a little on the lighter side. The last concussion I had basically took 2 weeks of memory out of my head, and I never got them back. I was in an ambulance on the way to the hospital, which I don't remember, came back home, and I had new furniture, new roommates. I did not recognize anything in my house. I also had changed jobs. My mother had to be with me for 2 days to make sure I wouldn't go to sleep because they feared I'd go into a coma. So I, being hard-headed as I am, decided after that to get back out on the track. And every time I'd land a jump, I felt my head throb inside my skull. It got to a point where that caused nausea, and then I gave it up.
Okay. Which, by the way, if you're interested, you can read that story on Kristy's blog on exerciseauthorities.com, right?
That's right.
Okay.
If you look at my news and specials page, that's where I keep all of this interesting information. And there's also useful stuff. It's not all about me. There's a lot of things that can help you via diet, nutrition, exercise ideas, and things of that nature as well.
But I think we've already established you're very interesting. Machinist to lawyer to motocross racer to concussion.
So, yeah, leaving off with the concussion. I went through a depression with not having all that adrenaline running through my system, so I put on some walking shoes, and during the nights when I normally would have been racing, I started walking, contemplating life, how boring life was. Now I'm walking. I used to fly through the air. So essentially what happened after probably a couple days of that, out of my anger at life, I took off running, screaming at the same time. Good thing I was living out in the country, because that would have been quite interesting, running in downtown Wausau, screaming at the same time.
It's not uncommon.
Yeah, it can be, I guess. So then I started running marathons, and I started fundraising for a corporation called Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Research Center out of New York. And what they did is, after we reached certain dollar amounts of raising funds, they would fly us to international marathon locations, and I selected to go to Italy. And